Hi, welcome back to Serenity Salon. It's so nice to see you again. Yes, I actually do have some extra time right now. What can I do for you today? You need your makeup done? Cool, sounds great. What kind of event will you be going to? A wedding? Aw, great. Are you going to be a bridesmaid? I figured. Well, you're going to be a very beautiful bridesmaid. Okay, so I think I have an idea for how we can do your makeup. I was thinking we can do a really light, natural foundation. You don't really need much coverage anyway. You have really nice skin. So we'll do a light foundation, and then we'll do like a coral, goldish colored blush, and then we'll also do a goldish colored eye, but make it kind of soft and not too harsh, and then a light pink lip. Does that sound good to you? Alright, great. I can't wait to see how it's going to turn out. Alright, so I guess we can just go ahead and get started. The first thing I'm going to do is use concealer. I really don't think that you need that much concealer. You have a few little spots I can cover up of redness. That's really all you need. So I'm going to use this. This is the L'Oreal True Match Crayon Concealer Pencil. And this is in the shade Light Medium. I think that matches your skin color pretty well. You're not dark. So I'll just roll this down a bit. And then you have a couple little spots I'm gonna cover up with this. And then one right here. Alright, good, good. And then I'll just blend that with my finger. So. Alright, great. Now, we're going to go ahead and do your foundation. And like I said, you really don't need much coverage, so I'm not going to use like a full foundation. I'm going to use a BB cream, which is pretty much like a tinted moisturizer. It's nice and light for a wedding. This is the Photo Ready BB cream, so it'll make your face look really great in photos. And this is also in the shade Light Medium. See little directions on the back, but you don't really need those. So I'm just gonna unscrew this, and I'm gonna squirt a little bit on my hand. Alright, I think that's all you'll need. One pump, that's usually what I use. Then I'm just gonna take it on my fingers. I wash my hands, don't worry. And then I'm just going to dab it on your face, so on your cheeks, and your nose, on your forehead, chin. Okay, now to blend that out. I'm going to take this brush, and this is just a foundation brush. It's tightly packed, and it helps to blend out liquids. Don't worry, I washed these as well. It's really soft. So, I'm just going to blend foundation into your eyes a little bit. I don't know if you can hear the rain outside, but it's really relaxing. Your forehead. so next I'm going to set your foundation with a powder. And this is L'Oreal True Match Super Blendable Powder in the shade Natural Buff. And this is just to set your foundation so that it won't wear off, and also so you won't look shiny. You'll look matte, and that's good for picture taking because you don't want the flash to reflect off of your face if you have any shininess. So we're not going to use too much of this. I'm going to use this brush. This is a really fluffy brush, and it's perfect for applying powder to your face because it gets, you know, wide coverage. This is really, really soft and fluffy. And it feels so good on your skin. So, I'm just gonna open this up. There's the powder. I'm just gonna swirl it in here. Tap off the excess. And then I'm going to just apply it everywhere that I applied foundation. So, really flawless now. Alright, so next I'm just going to use a little bit of bronzer. We're not going to do too much because, like I said, I want to keep your face nice and natural. But I'm just going to use this half, the color on this half, and I'm going to put it in the hollows of your cheeks and on your temples, and this will make the appearance that your face is a little bit slimmer, especially in photos. That looks really nice. And it's called contouring. It's thundering a little bit now, too. Okay. For this, I'm going to use this brush. And this is just this is a little bit more accurate for contouring. You can apply it in a little specific area. And that's what you want to do when you contour, is get a specific area. This is also really soft, and the reason it probably just fell apart is because when I washed it, it probably got some water down in there and undid the glue. But it's okay, I can re-glue that. It's still really soft, and it'll work really well. So I'm just going to use the color on this side because we don't want you to look orange. So, okay. Can you do this for me? Thank you. And then apply it to the hollows of your cheek. Next, I'm going to go ahead and do your blush, and I'm going to use this blush. It's a Milani Baked Blush, and this one is in the shade Rose d'Oro, and this one is a really nice pinky golden color, and when you put it on, it's not too pink at all. It's the perfect golden color for subtle face, like for a wedding, or you know, anything where you don't want too harsh makeup. So for this one, I'm going to use this brush, and this has a little slight angle to it, and that's perfect for your cheeks. This is another one that's really soft. Really enjoy brushes. They're really soft and feel really nice on your face. I also love getting my makeup done. It's so relaxing. I'm just gonna get a little blush, tap off the excess, and once again, and I'm going to apply that on your cheekbone. Now your skin looks so flawless and glowing and healthy and really beautiful. Okay, so next we'll work on your eyes. The first thing I'm going to do is use a primer, and that will help your eyeshadows to stay on all day and not fade. And this is an Urban Decay eyeshadow primer. So I'm just going to unscrew it. And get the excess off. You don't need too much of this. And I'm going to apply it on your eyelids. Can you close them for me? Thank you. We're going to do this one. And now your other one. Alright, great. Great. Okay, close them one more time for me, and I'm going to blend that. Next, we're going to go ahead and apply your eyeshadows, and I'm going to be using an eyeshadow palette from Urban Decay, and this is called the Naked Palette. It's actually made of like a felt material. I love the sound it makes. Up, and on the inside are all these wonderful neutral colors. What I was thinking we could do for your eyeshadow look is apply this golden color to your lids for a nice subtle but still shimmery look, and then we could apply this color and this color mixed together in your crease just to give you a little definition and shadow and not make it too much. And then use this white color here for a highlight under your brow bone and in your inner tear duct to make your eyes really open and pop. How does that sound? Alright, great. Okay, so first I'm going to use this brush. It's by Urban Decay, and it's an eyeshadow brush. And it's really packed tightly for good application of shadow. I'm just going to put it in the gold color that I showed you here. Okay, so I want you to close your eyes for me, and I'm going to apply this all over your eyelids. Thank you. Next, sorry, I'm going to take this brush, and this is a fluffy brush, and this is by Eco Tools. And the purpose of this brush is to fit in the crease of your eye, right where your eyelid meets your brow bone. And this will give you a little bit of definition and shadow. So firstly, I'm going to use this darker brown color here. And I'm picking that up here. And I'm going to use that to set the shadow in the crease. So close your eye for me. Great, thank you. I'm just going to apply that in the crease like so. In a little windshield wiper motion. Alright, great. Now I'm just going to use the same brush. I'm just going to tap off that brown. And I'm picking up this lighter brown. And I'm going to blend that from the top of the brown upwards so the color feathers out and it's not too harsh, okay? So it's even higher. Other one. Alright, great. Now, I'm going to take this brush, and this is an angle, just like our cheekbone brush was. And this one's really soft as well. And I'm going to dip this one in the white. I'm going to put it right on your brow bone, right underneath your eyebrow, and this will highlight it and make your eyes pop. So, I'm putting that up top. Okay. And then also with the white, I'm going to take this little brush. It's tiny and very precise. And with the white, I'm going to put it on your inner tear duct. And that will open up your eyes and make them pop. So you can leave them open now. Okay. And then just putting it in that tear duct. And then this one. Okay, great. And now for the finishing touches with the eyeshadow, I'm going to take this little round brush, just even more precise. I'm going to take the same gold color that I put on your lid. And I'm going to put it underneath your eye, right up against your lash line, for a little golden touch under the eye. So I want you to look up for me. Great, thank you. And I'm just going to put that under your eye. And other one. Alright, very nice, very nice. Alright, so we are done with the eyeshadow. But I'm also going to use this palette for one more thing while we have it open, and that is for your eyebrows. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a dark color. I'm going to take this one here, and I'm just going to fill in your eyebrows where there may be any like white space in them, so they just look more defined. It's not going to make them darker or anything like that, I promise. So I'm just taking this little brush that we used for your inner tear duct, and I'm going to take that color, and I'm just going to fill in your brows where I may see a little bit of blank space, which is usually just in the very beginning, and then use it to define that arch a little bit. Very good. And then this one, and define the arch. Alright, great, great. And now, I'm going to take this little comb, it's for your eyebrows, and I'm going to comb them straight so the hairs are all in place. And then this one. Okay. And now that all the hairs are in place, let me close this real quick, sorry. Now that the hairs are in place, I'm going to take this mini mascara. This is by Wet n Wild, and this is a brown color, and hairs are in place, I'm going to use this mascara gel just to set the hairs. They'll stay. Going to do a little bit of eyeliner, and since we put gold on your bottom lash line, I'm not going to put anything down there because that's going to make the eyes too dark. I'm just going to take this brown eyeliner pencil by Wet n Wild, and I'm going to just put a thin line on your upper lash line just to define your eye a little bit, okay? So close your eye for me. Great, okay. I'm just going to put this on your upper lash line, just a slight bit. Okay, and other eye. Okay, great, that looks great. Alright, now for the finishing touches to your eyes. I'm going to curl your eyelashes and apply a little bit of mascara, okay? So what I need you to do is look very, very straight, and I'm going to guide your eyelashes into this. Don't worry, it's not going to hurt. And then close them around your lashes. Pulse it. All right, great. And your other eye. All right, fantastic. And then I'm going to apply some waterproof mascara just in case you might cry at the wedding or anything like that. And this is CoverGirl Volume Exact Waterproof Hydrofuge Mascara. And I love the smell of mascara. Some people hate it, but I love it. And this sound. So I want you to just look really, really straight at me and try not to blink right now, okay? This will be over soon. I'm just gonna put this on your lashes. And this is just gonna make your eyelashes look really long and thick and make your eyes stand out. Blink break. Okay, one more time. Go over them. Great, now this eye. Blink. Okay, here we go. And then one more time. Alright, and then I'll dip it back in and get your bottom lashes. Just a little bit, just to define them. So look straight. Okay, and then this eye. Alright, fantastic. You look so beautiful. And all I have to do now is the finishing touches, which is the lips. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this. This is a Revlon Just Bitten Kissable Lip Balm. And this is in a really nude color. And this will just be kind of like a concealer on your lips, and it will cancel out your lip color, so that whatever lip color I put on top will pop out, okay? So just do your lips like that, like tight. Okay, I'm gonna just put this on your lips. And your upper lip. All right, now do that. Very good. Now we're going to put the lip color, and this is a Revlon lip butter in the shade Strawberry Shortcake. And it's just a really, really light, pretty pink. It's not too pink. It's not going to be like a bright pink. It's just a light, neutral pink, kind of like the color of my lips. And it'll just make them look really natural but shiny. So do this for me. Alright. Just put that on your lips. Great, and you can just do that one more time. Alright. Okay, well, think I am done doing your makeup. You look really, really beautiful right now. I think you're gonna look so amazing in your dress as a bridesmaid at the wedding. That's gonna be $25, please. I hope you enjoy your makeup, and I hope you have an amazing, fantastic time at your wedding and make some wonderful memories. I'll see you soon then. Thank you for stopping by Serenity Salon. Bye. Flawless now. Alright, so next, I'm just going to use a little bit of bronzer. We're not going to do too much because, like I said, I want to keep your face nice and natural. But I'm just going to use this half, the color on this half, and I'm going to put it in the hollows of your cheeks and on your temples, and this will make the appearance that your face is a little bit slimmer, especially in photos. That looks really nice. And it's called contouring. It's thundering a little bit now, too. Okay. For this, I'm going to use this brush. And this is just this is a little bit more accurate for contouring. You can apply it in a little specific area. And that's what you want to do when you contour, is get a specific area. This is also really soft, and the reason it probably just fell apart is because when I washed it, it probably got some water down in there and undid the glue. But it's okay, I can re-glue that. It's still really soft, and it'll work really well. So I'm just going to use the color on this side because we don't want you to look orange. So, okay. Can you do this for me? Thank you. And then apply it to the hollows of your cheek. I don't know if you can hear the rain outside, but it's really relaxing. Your forehead. Alright, great. So, just make some touch-ups. Alright. Great. Okay, so next I'm going to set your foundation with a powder. And this is L'Oreal True Match Super Blendable Powder in the shade Natural Buff. And this is just to set your foundation so that it won't wear off, and also so you won't look shiny. You'll look matte, and that's good for picture taking because you don't want the flash to reflect off of your face if you have any shininess. We're not going to use too much of this. I'm going to use this brush. This is a really fluffy brush, and it's perfect for applying powder to your face because it gets, you know, wide coverage. This is really, really soft and fluffy. And it feels so good on your skin. So, I'm just going to open this up. There's the powder. Just gonna swirl it in here, tap off the excess, and then I'm going to just apply it everywhere that I applied foundation. So, cheek, and your nose, and your other cheek. Hi, welcome back to Serenity Salon. It's so nice to see you again. Yes, I actually do have some extra time right now. What can I do for you today? You need your makeup done? Cool, sounds great. What kind of event will you be going to? A wedding? Aw, great. Are you going to be a bridesmaid? I figured. Well, you're going to be a very beautiful bridesmaid. Okay, so I think I have an idea for how we can do your makeup. I was thinking we can do a really light, natural foundation. You don't really need much coverage anyway. You have really nice skin. So we'll do a light foundation, and then we'll do like a coral goldish colored blush, and then we'll also do a goldish colored eye, but make it kind of soft and not too harsh. And then a light pink lip. Does that sound good to you? All right, great. I can't wait to see how it's going to turn out. All right, so I guess we can just go ahead and get started. The first thing I'm going to do is use concealer. I really don't think that you need that much concealer. No. You have a few little spots I can cover up of redness. That's really all you need. So I'm going to use this. This is the L'Oreal True Match Crayon Concealer Pencil. And this is in the shade Light Medium. I think that matches your skin color pretty well. You're not dark. So I'll just roll this down a bit. And then you have a couple little spots I'm gonna cover up with this. And then one right here. Alright, good, good. And then I'll just blend that with my finger. So. Alright, great. Now we're going to go ahead and do your foundation, and like I said, you really don't need much coverage, so I'm not going to use like a full foundation. I'm going to use a BB cream, which is pretty much like a tinted moisturizer. It's nice and light for a wedding. This is the Photo Ready BB cream, so it'll make your face look really great in photos, and this is also in the shade Light Medium. See little directions on the back, but you don't really need those. So I'm just gonna unscrew this, and I'm gonna squirt a little bit on my hand. All right, I think that's all you'll need. One pump, that's usually what I use. And I'm just gonna take it on my fingers. I wash my hands, don't worry. And then I'm just going to dab it on your face, so on your cheeks, and your nose, on your forehead, chin. Okay, now to blend that out. I'm going to take this brush, and this is just a foundation brush. It's tightly packed, and it helps to blend out liquids. Don't worry, I washed these as well. It's really soft. So, I'm just going to blend foundation into your eyes a little bit. Thank you. And then do your temples. Next, I'm going to go ahead and do your blush, and I'm going to use this blush. It's a Milani Baked Blush, and this one is in the shade Rose D'Oro, and this one is a really nice pinky golden color, and when you put it on, it's not too pink at all. It's the perfect golden color for subtle face like for a wedding or, you know, anything where you don't want too harsh makeup. So for this one, I'm going to use this brush. And this has a little slight angle to it, and that's perfect for your cheeks. This is another one that's really soft. Really enjoy brushes. They're really soft and feel really nice on your face. I also love getting my makeup done. It's so relaxing. I'm just gonna get a little blush, tap off the excess, and once again, can you? Okay, and I'm going to apply.